Alright, here we go. I just pearled. Oh, he followed, rescue me! Oh! I got him! Right. I'm prone on you.
Warmed up right now.
I just came and took the one tap!
I need the hype. Throw that to the sky.
Here, welcome back to another video on Valor. Guys, if you aren't already connected, go ahead and do so. The IP is on screen right now, play.valorhgf.net. Today is Start of the World, my favorite day of the week. Start of the Worlds are always the most fun. And today we're doing something brand new. I'm not sure if anyone has done this yet. My boy Andy, the one that makes all the traps, recommended me to do this series, and it is Living in the Nether. So basically, I literally will not have a claim. I won't have any way to F home. And if I go fight in the overworld, I have nowhere to go except to try and find another portal and get back to base through there. So basically, I have nothing claimed. I have to hide my chest. I have to do all of that and hope that no one finds them and takes all my loot. I think it's gonna be pretty fun. It's definitely gonna be a challenge, but I think we can get through it. So I'm very excited for the series, and hopefully you guys are too. As you guys can see behind me, you guys are probably like, what the heck? I've never seen this room before. It's actually a hidden room on the Valor Hub. If you guys haven't found it, go ahead and try and find it. It is somewhere in the hub. This is my my little bedroom here. It's pretty dope. But guys, right now we're just in the hub waiting to queue up, waiting for them to let us into the server, and then we are gonna get started. I am actually gonna be playing with Hate because I'm helping him with his series as well, so I will be in Hatefu's faction and I will be helping him set up his base in the overworld and stuff like that, but I'm not living there. I'm living in the Nether. Also guys, the last Start of the World video, I was doing an Emperor rank giveaway, and I have a winner right here for you. The winner is Hubre. His comment is on screen now. Congratulations, you have won Emperor rank. You should have it once you log on right now. You guys, you already know we got another giveaway. We're gonna be giving away 10 partner packages. If you guys want to enter in a chance at winning that, make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel, like today's video, comment your IGN and something you like about the server, and you'll— oh my god, we also just got into the freaking server. I have to go get started really quick, but make sure you guys enter in. Let's get started with today's video. Make sure to drop a like down below, subscribe if you guys are new, and let's get right into the video. Alrighty guys, so we are at the spawn. It just let us in, as you guys just saw. I have to do my reclaim. I have to give some money to Hatefu to make sure he gets a good enough claim. So let me go ahead and sell some stuff really quick. We don't really have to worry about a claim because all we have to do is just run through this Nether portal and go find a spot to make a base. I'm gonna open all these keys really quick. Here we go. Let me go sell some vowels for Hate. I want to make sure he has enough money to get a decent claim. All right, we're gonna open up the owner crate keys right now. We usually always get some pretty freaking good stuff in here. All the custom enchanted sets. Boom, there we go. We got a full set off of that. Pretty freaking nice. All right, so now we gotta open up the mystery box key. My favorite key on the server. If you guys haven't gotten a mystery box key before, you might want to try it out. You guys can have a chance at winning some pretty freaking good stuff. You literally have a chance at winning all of the kits, and also all of the kits literally for 2 weeks as well. You can also win ranks. You can also win partner packages, stuff like that. Everything in here is amazing. The mystery box key is my favorite one. So let's go ahead, open it up and see what we get. All right, it is spinning, and we got all of the kits for 2 weeks. That's a freaking GG right there. As you guys know, I already do have all of the kits, and I'm pretty sure Hatefu does as well. So I guess I'm gonna give away one of these as well. So I'm giving away 10 partner packages, and I'm also giving away the all kits for 2 weeks. So if you guys want a chance at winning this as well, make sure you put all kits somewhere in there so I know that you want all kits instead of the 10 partner packages. This will also be picked the next Start of the World. This thing's pretty OP. I literally have full access to all the kits. This is what all kits means. You have access to every kit in here for 2 weeks. You're basically set for the map if you have this, so make sure to enter in that as well. But okay, we have 10 partner packages to open. I'm gonna go ahead and open them. I don't want them to fill up my whole entire inventory. I don't think they will. Three more. Boom, there we go. Okay, we got a bunch of Dre debuff, Hefu's inhibitor, and Dylan's shell, and then some Riley rings. Pretty freaking good. We are stocked up on those. Let me go sell these vowels, and we'll get right through that Nether portal. Okay guys, so like I said before, we are not going down South Road like we usually do. We are taking a trip to Nether, so let's go ahead, hop on through. All right, we have made it. It is a completely different vibe here. As you guys know, you can't claim in Nether, so what I'm gonna have to do is take away my cord so you guys can't freaking see me, and I'm gonna go find a spot to live. So let me go ahead, do that really quick, and hide these. Okay, my cords are now hidden. You will not be able to see where I am. I'm not gonna tell you if I'm gonna go down South, North, West, or East Road. Not telling you. So what I'm gonna do right now is go find a spot to live, somewhere where I can store all my stuff, put my chest, all that good stuff, and hopefully not get raided. So I'll bring you guys back in a second once I find that, and then hopefully we can get a little action going. Okay guys, so I just found a spot that I am going to be living, and I just mined it out. You guys I don't think are gonna be able to find me. If someone is able to find my chest room during the series and leaves like a sign or something, if you find it off camera, just don't break it. All right, just don't break my stuff, all right, please. But if you do find it, leave a sign with your IGN somewhere in this base. It's gonna be filled with like chests and stuff like that, so leave it signed somewhere, and I will give you a special surprise. I guarantee you will like it. I'm not gonna tell you what it is just because I don't want to get everyone too hype and trying to find my base. But if you do find
find it.
Put a sign.
And you'll get something special.
And if my base isn't destroyed as well, you'll get something even more special.
So yeah, there's a little challenge for you guys to do.
Right now, I'm actually going to do my kit so I can set up the chest.
I believe it is in Trapper Kit. Yep, there we go. There's the wood. Let me go ahead and get rid of the water. Obviously, we don't need that. Oh, geez, dude. I don't want all these blocks to clear. Come on.
Slash raft.
Here we go. Let me make a bunch of chests. Okay, here we go. Now we got some stuff going.
I really hope someone doesn't randomly find me. I don't think they will. I'm in a pretty secure location, but if they do, I'm actually going to be kind of salty. I'm going to be mostly relying on the pots from my kit and the pots from the people that I kill. I'm obviously going to make brewing stands and stuff like that. I'm definitely not going to make an auto brew here. I might actually be going overworld to get some pots from Heifu and stuff like that. They might have to resupply me with some stuff. But for the most part, we're staying in here. It's going to be hell all week, if you know what I mean.
I know. I'm a jokester. Don't worry. I get it all the time.
But all right, we need to snazz this room up a little bit because it's a little dull. I'm going to set all the chests up, get some brewing stands going, and then I will bring you guys back. We're also going to be doing some traps as well to hopefully quick drop some players, get their sets. And I think Heifu's going to help me out with that as well because I'm probably going to need help killing them just in case it's a bigger faction. But yeah, let me set up the base and I'll bring you guys back in a second.
Alrighty, guys, we are back and the little base is set up. It's looking pretty good. Come on now. I feel like it did all right. I don't know. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think of this little base.
And honestly, it doesn't even look like we're in the nether besides the lava that I put in behind us just to give it some more texture and beauty. But okay, now that we have pretty much everything set up that we really need, I'm gonna go ahead and do all my kits. I actually did my G kit bard already, so I have to wait on that, but I haven't done any of my other kits, so I'm gonna go ahead and do them. As you guys know, the only kits you get with potions is a diamond kit and overlord kit. Everything else, you just get the armor, and I actually already did my miner set as well prior to building this because I had to mine down and stuff. So I only have a few more kits to open up. Oh yeah, I also did my brewer kit obviously to set up the brewing stand, so I already did that, and I did my trapper kit to set up the chest. So we're pretty much through all of them except the grinder kit. We can do this was actually pretty sick if you're trying to make a god set, and it also gives you a freaking OP sword. Okay, we have the kits that we can do with pots now. There we go. I don't want anything to spawn. Put that in here. Boom bada bing. Now we got an OP set. Some seed pots and invis. That is always good to see. Some pearls right there. We'll put that there. Slash G kit. And now we have, actually I'm gonna take off this set just because I'm gonna use the overlord set right now. And actually, for right now, I'll just put everything in the chest except this stuff. This G kit, overlord, the best G kit. And there we go. I'm also gonna keep this god apple in here. Actually, I'm gonna keep, since we're in the nether, guys, I'm gonna keep the bow on me at all times, because if I get someone in lava and I have this bow on me, they're pretty much done. So we'll keep that out and ready to shoot at someone. Right now, since we really don't have to do any other base work, kind of want to keep it small just so people don't see it. Another really good thing to do is make sure your base is surrounded by lava just in case there's any like hackers out there or cheaters. I'm pretty sure you can't see through lava or something like that during x-ray. So make sure you surround your bases with lava, your nether bases, if it's not claimed. That's always good to do in factions as well. If you guys have ever played factions, you usually cover your base with lava or something like that and keep it kind of small so it's kind of avoidable so no one can really see it. So right now our main goal is to pretty much brew up some pots. So I do have a bunch of potion materials right here, but I don't have any melons, glycerin melons. So I'm actually gonna have to take a trip to spawn right now. I have to get all the main essentials to brew real quick, and then I think we're gonna take a trip to glowstone, check that out, see if we can load up on a little bit more glowstone and gunpowder and see if anyone's there. So I'm gonna head to spawn real quick, get some of the basic essentials, and then we'll get started with brewing from there. Alrighty guys, we made it to spawn. It is time to get the materials. Also, when I came through, I just realized, what if I were to make a nether portal in my base, in nether? The only thing I'm afraid of is if I make it in there, other people will teleport and come through it, and then they'll literally be in my base. But then again, it could be a good idea, because what if I made it like a trap so they came through and then maybe I surrounded it with obsidian as well, so it was hard for them to get out. I don't know. It's an idea. I could try it. I kind of want to try it. So I think that's what we're going to do next. But first, obviously, we need to get our materials. I'm going to get some more nether wart really quick and stock up on there. Okay, that should be good for now. And then we need to buy a crap ton of glycerin melon. All right, that should be good for the glycerin melon. And then what else could we possibly need? I think that might be it. Yeah, okay. I think that's it. So as you know, I can't have foam. I have to go back through the nether portal. Oh, wait, I forgot. I have, since the first hour is up, I have a medieval key and a partner package that I can open. So let me go ahead and open this medieval key real quick. Okay, perfect. We just got portable ward and 16 extra pearls. Not too shabby from that. I will gladly take that. And now partner package. Boom, Dre's debuff and a pickaxe. Not too bad at all either. All right, now we have to take our journey back to our base. We have to run all the way there. You guys don't know where it is. Honestly, I kind of forget where it is too. Oh my god, I didn't even set a waypoint. Okay, wait, no. I think I know where it is if I remember.
remember. I'm gonna try and find my way back to the base. I'll bring you guys back there. Hopefully I make it back safe and sound, and hopefully no one follows me from over there. But all right, I will see you guys back at the base. All right, guys, we made it back to our base. It took me a bit. I honestly forgot where I went at first, but then it all came back to me, so I found it right away. We're good to go. But okay, we have a bunch of materials right now. We have everything we need for brewing health pots. So what we're gonna do right now is just brew up some and fill up this dub of pots. There's 33 more minutes until the start of the world timer ends, so I just want to get some pots just in case I get jumped. I'm also gonna redeem these, both of these, into strength twos, just because I don't know if I'll be by myself for some of these, so I'm gonna need to have strength two. I also need to make sure I keep that overlord bow in there. But okay, I'm gonna make some potions right now. We have a little bit of glass. I'll bring you guys back after, because I'm sure you don't want to watch me just sit here and brew pots. It's pretty boring to watch. And I just realized I need water to brew pots. All right, well, I'm gonna go to spawn real quick. I'm gonna empty my whole entire inventory and just have these bottles in here just so I can get as much as I can get. I'm gonna get enough just to fill the whole inventory so I don't have any left over. I think this is the smartest move I can do. 36, there we go. 36 bottles, it'll fill my whole entire inventory, and then we'll take another trip while they are brewing. So I'm gonna head back to spawn. I completely forgot I can't get water. Oh my god, dude. This is gonna be a force to brew pots. All right, well, I'll see you guys in a second. Alrighty, guys, we made it back with an inventory of pots. It took a little bit, but we are finally back. I'm gonna go ahead and fill these up, start brewing some health pots. I'm gonna take probably one more trip, maybe two more trips after I brew all these up, just so I can get just around a dub of pots. Oh crap, I just realized I can't set the hoppers up on that. Okay, I gotta move those down. Let me get my pickaxe again. Okay, there we go. All right, I'm gonna brew up some health pots. I'm gonna take one more trip while these are all brewing, and then I'll have around a double pot, so I'll bring you guys back after, and then by then hopefully we can start getting some action. What I really want to do is there's gonna be key alls, and most of the people go through nether portals and then run through nether to spawn, just because it's a lot shorter distance. So I think a good tactic for me is to catch people while they're trying to run to spawn and then pick off kills from there. So I think that's the first thing that I'm gonna do to try and get some kills. I don't know, I think that's the best idea for me. I really want to set up a nether portal in here just in case some people come through, because I'll be able to trap them. So I'm gonna go to spawn real quick, get some more water bottles. Let me actually dump these out really quick. I'm gonna go to spawn, get some more water bottles. I'm actually gonna get in a call with Hate really quick, ask him if he has any obsidian, and then I'm gonna bring it back here and hopefully build another portal just for an easy way to get to spawn, and possibly some people will come through this portal. I don't know how it works, but I think it could work. But yeah, as you see up on the right side, we have my key all in about 20 minutes, so right after the start of the world timer ends, which is perfect. So I'll bring you guys back after all this is done, and start of the world timer is just about to end. Alrighty guys, we are back. We did some brewing. Also, the start of the world timer got extended a little bit just because there is a reboot coming up. So sadly, I won't be able to time anyone with my key all, because obviously I won't be able to hit anyone. So we're about to get the key all right now. I have a slot open. I'm actually gonna have to run back to spawn again. But we just brewed up some pots. We have about a dub. Yeah, we have a full dub right here. I actually added some pots from the diamond kit in there as well. So we have a full dub of health pots. We're looking good to go. I also went over to Hate's base and he gave me some obsidian to make another portal. I don't need to put any fence gates or anything, obviously, because there's no claim here, so I might as well just keep it open. And I asked Hate, I was like, dude, do you know if anyone will be able to come through the nether portal? He said he's pretty sure it's impossible that anyone can come through here. So I think I'm safe. I think I'm good to go. I'm not too sure. This won't actually take me to spawn, I don't think. Yeah, I think it's just gonna take me to another location. Yeah, I haven't went through. It went past the border, so it went inward. Where are we in the cords? I don't think you guys see. Dude, all right, well, we're not gonna be using this portal at all, because you guys can't see my cords, but we're at negative 3,000 right now, so there's no reason for me to do that. Screw that, we're going back through. Okay, well, that's fine though. I can use it to teleport, I guess, because yeah, now we're closer to spawn, and then I don't have to mine out of my base or mine in my base at all, so I guess that's easier. But okay, we're gonna go to spawn real quick because we just got my key, and then we're gonna wait for the reboot. So I'll bring you guys back, and hopefully we can get some PvP action. I'm pretty sure the first Koth going up right now is gonna be Nether Koth, so I will definitely get some action. And I think I'm gonna hop in a call with Hate because he's gonna help me murder some people in Nether. So let's head to spawn real quick and open my key. All right guys, there's a minute 50 left until the Hate Food key comes, so I'm gonna go up top. I just got a full loadout again. I'm gonna go and wait at spawn really quick, or the Nether spawn, and hopefully I can get some people coming through Nether, and hopefully I don't die this time. So Hate, I don't know if you want to meet up with me or not.
Yep,
but
I'm coming right now.
Yeah, I'm gonna camp out outside of south side of Nether spawn, and hopefully we can get someone. So I'll bring guys back when we're there. Here we go. Dude, he's like, what is he doing, dude?
Yeah, I know. He's like acting like nothing's gonna happen. Like he's not gonna die, but he's gonna die.
I can still use my speed three whenever.
Save that. Oh no!
No way. This is not his faction. This is a different faction. Stick him.
No. Dude, these people are gonna fucking steal it, Chase.
Dude, yeah.
No, I'm gonna steal
it. Dude, it's Riley again. Are you kidding me, dude?
I'm gonna try to message Riley. No, dude, message. Dude.
Come on, dude. They're gonna get it. They're gonna try and steal it. They're about to kill him right here. He's so low. I don't know if I should use a speed 3 or not on him. Should I use a speed 3 or not?
They stop. No, don't.
All right, there we go. I got a 1.7 on him. He ate a crapple. Dude, he's not good at running. I haven't pinned him. Dead.
Oh, let's go. Easy. I got the key. Easy. Oh, he has 2 snowballs.
Is it a good set? Oh, it is a good set, dude.
Dude, no way he was. Look how broken it is, Chase. There's no way we chased him for that long. What the fuck?
Dude,
he had a medieval key as well. Look.
Oh, beautiful.
I'm in a big spawn run.
Hell yeah. All right, well, how is his armor so broken? He must have been getting dirty with some other people.
Yeah.
We did not do that much damage to him, but all right, first one down. Wait, should we go spawn right now, or should we wait at south side again?
I don't know, these people, dude, doing the same thing.
He said Ziggy was just trying to open keys because I'm poor. I feel bad.
I'm sorry, dude, I'm sorry.
Wait, so you said you think we should open them now?
Let's not take their kills, but let's go on our own. Yeah, they're choosing it up.
Are they?
We're good, yeah.
All right, I got out of here, dude. Okay, we're good. All right, let's just go open these keys then, I guess, because they're freaking taking over another right now. All right, you have 2 of your keys, right? All right, I'm going to open the medieval key first and then see what we can get. Boom. All right, I got 4 end portal frames and 16 pearls out of that.
Got some armor, speed book, and looting sword and bow.
Now I'm going to open your key and... All right, I got some pants off of that and then one of your bows. Not too bad. Not too freaking bad. All right, I'm going to go... I think I need to go back and store... Yeah, I need to go back.
Yeah.
I'm going to store my stuff and then I think we're going to head to Koth in a few minutes, and it's supposed to come up, right? Pretty sure.
Yeah.
So I think Nether Koth is first up, so we're gonna head there after I store stuff, and hopefully we can kill some people. Alrighty, guys. So as you guys can see right now, I am in Overworld, and that is because I've been helping out Hatefu record his videos, and I kind of needed to see some daylight. All right, back there it's pretty hot, and I didn't want to just burn up, so I'm gonna go back Nether right now. Though we need to go back. We can't stay in Overworld too long. I think Hate might come help me get a few more clips, but I want to go through this portal and see if there's anyone right here that I can start. Okay, well, nice, dude. Are you gonna sit there and just hit me out the whole thing or what? All right, there we go. We're through. No one is here. Okay, yes, this is the same portal that everyone uses, because remember we passed by this before earlier in the video and I pointed it out. So I guess this is the main portal for everyone. No one is here by the looks of it. Oh my god. Okay, we're good. We didn't die. Well, we're gonna head back to our base right now. We need to organize some things. Hate actually gave me a set because I didn't have one because I died while helping him. So we have a fresh set and a fresh loadout. Thank you to Hate. But yeah, we're gonna go back to base real quick and check it out, make sure it's still intact, and then we'll go from there. Alrighty, guys, so Andy is here. He is gonna be making me a fall trap right now in the Nether. As you guys can see, up there is where the portal is to come through. That's pretty much everyone's portal. So once we make this faller, we're gonna dig out a little section. It's literally gonna be right here. I'm gonna go ahead and bait some kids and act like I'm cutting. Hopefully I can get jumped by a faction, and then we'll bait them over here. Boom, pearl in that little section, and hopefully some people fall for it and we can get them. So we're gonna make this real quick and I'll bring you guys back in a second. Alrighty, guys, so we just finished out digging out and replacing everything with crafting tables, and we got Hero up there right now. He's in Bard set. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna F home. I know I'm not supposed to go Overworld, but I'm just gonna F home just so I can go back through the portal and either bait someone through or hopefully catch someone off guard when they come through, and then act like I'm poop, and then hopefully they'll target me. So we're gonna try that really quick. I'm actually gonna grab an invis as well just so they don't see my name, and then I'm just gonna basically splash pots everywhere and hopefully that they'll follow us. So I'm gonna go through the portal right now and let's see if we can get anyone. He just died to fall damage. He had to have peed one. Oh my god,
made him raidable.
He had a mystery key. I made him raidable.
Yeah.
Oh my, I got a medieval key from him. Oh wait, we just got a freaking battle pass challenge done from him, made him raidable, got Dylan shells and a key off of that one freaking kill. All right, I just repotted. I'm coming back through right now. Let's see if we can get anyone. I don't know how long. Oh wait, there's someone. Oh, there's someone down there. There's literally someone. Oh, it's a freaking naked dude. I'm gonna eliminate him real quick. Dude, I feel so bad. I literally just pearled down on this kid and one tapped him in there, into the lava.
Wait, in the pool.
Into the lava. He was just a naked. Oh, we got one right here. We got a guy.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna fight him right here on road. I'm gonna have to act like I'm poopy though, so he follows me. Here we go. Come on, boy. What you got? Oh, wait, this is wee wee bag, bro. This guy freaking pisses me off all the time. All right, you're dying today. Time for some freaking payback. I'm gonna use a Dre debuff on you. Oh my god. Yeah, that's right, boy. Ooh! He almost got me on that one. I'm not gonna lie. All right, act poop real quick. I'm just throwing pots around. Wait, I can't crapple yet. All right. Dude, he dead ass almost just quick drop. I'm fucking him up right now. Okay, I'm heading towards there right now. Dude, I honestly think I'm freaking winning in the 1v1 against him right now, though. So I might just freaking try and quick drop. Oh, the noobs. The noob was just comboing him. All right, here we go. I just pearled. Oh, he fouled. Rest me. Oh, I got him. Right. Oh, no. Dude, he's going to get me in it, though. He's going to get me. I'm dead. No. I'm dead. Hate go. I knew I was gonna die, dude. Like, I'm so bad.
Oh.
Oh, Hero died. We gotta go. Hey,
it's me. I'm here.
You're down there?
I'm round three, yeah.
Round three, okay. I'm coming out as well. I see you.
Okay.
As long as you didn't
get
out.
Did you probably use a partner item, fam?
Huh?
I can't, like, I'm not, like...
I'm prone on you,
warmed up right now.
Oh! Came and took the one tap!
Oh, there's a bunch of stuff over here. It's hero stuff, dude. Holy crap. And dude, he got two of us, bro. That's
dude,
embarrassing.
Yeah,
case.
Yeah. Dude, I literally had you. You can't get mad at me, all right? You can't make fun of me. You can't get mad at me.
I trapped him.
He sucked. He fell for the trap.
All right. Exactly.
In the long run, we got all the sets back and we got some extra stuff. So that was a freaking GG. That was a freaking GG. All right, Hate and I are heading back to my base right now to store all the loot that we just got off of the kill that we got. Should be around here somewhere.
Can you guys see out?
Yeah, here. Isn't it right under here?
Yeah, somewhere right around here.
Oh, I don't have fire rest, Chase. No.
Dude,
help me.
You're good. Here.
Oh my god. Yeah, I'm barely taking damage. I'm good.
All right.
Holy fuck.
All right, let's go store all the loot. Alrighty, guys, we made it safe and sound back to the base. First episode is down, and we didn't get our base raided. Nothing happened, so I'm pretty happy with everything. Hate is also joined here in the base. But guys, I think that is a good point to end off today's video. We just got a trap kill at the end with that faller. Not too bad for our first day at living in the Nether. Hopefully, you guys did enjoy. If you did, please be sure to drop a like down below. Subscribe if you guys are new, and I'll see you all in the next episode. Peace. We'll be right back.